while the regional offices are located in all provinces headquarters, including Punjab, Sindh, KPK, and Balochistan. HEP is registered as a non-profit organization, duly registered with the Security and Exchange Commission of Pakistan, SECP. Its statements of accounts are audited by a chartered accounting firm and same are submitted to the SEP in line with the regulatory requirements. The Handicraft Association is mainly aims to promote the use of current market trends and modern technology in line with the current market practice, whereby ensuring development of exports of handicrafts. To promote, develop, aid, stimulate, protect, and encourage handicrafts making and trading industry in Pakistan. Its aim to develop and convert the informal handicraft sectors into a formal industry. Handicraft Association of Pakistan participates and arranges delegations, exhibitions, trade fairs worldwide to develop a thriving export market. It encourages and facilitates trainings within SAARC region and continuously works towards involving a joint strategy in the best interest of handicraft sector with the government of Pakistan and other trade body. We recommend all people and TDAP to join hands with Handicraft Association and to promote the handicraft industry. I request you all also join our handicraft store. It's an online store. It works globally to promote our cultural and heritage sectors throughout the world. Thank you. I am Halima Usman. My contact details are shared in the chat box. You can contact me whenever and whatever you want to query for Handicraft Association of Pakistan. I again thankful to TDAP and all its team to facilitate handicraft sector and arranging these valuable and informative seminars and webinars. Thank you, Ji. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you, Hasan.
Thank you very much, ma'am. So we designed this concept in very close collaboration with the Handicraft Association of Pakistan. And Mr. Fahad Barlas, who's the former chairperson of the Handicraft Association of Pakistan, we sat together and we came up with this concept in which we would have the foreign missions involved and we would try to tap market opportunities abroad. So in order to orient our participants as to how to make the best use of this webinar, I would invite Mr. Fahad Barlas to please say a few words. Sir, the floor is yours now.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you, Mr. Hassan. And I'd like to congratulate the entire team of Trade Development Authority of Pakistan and in particularly Director General Shahzad Ahmed Khan Saab. And for today, we have Mr. Irfan, who's Trade and Investment Counselor at Gangzu, and Mr. Mahmood Akhtar, who's Acting Counsel General at Chengdu. So for I'll be very, very brief and very short actually, that South China is actually the cradle of, Chinese modern industrial civilization. So when we think of Gangzhou, South China, Guangdong province, or even the entire southern Chinese region, the sense of entrepreneurship, the way they have evolved over the last three decades is an example for entire world. So we have to now this region has evolved from from an industrial base to now it's very rapidly becoming more of an service oriented. So now we having a more margin of pitching this market as the handicraft the base in Pakistan. So I'll try to push our handicraft base, the members, that please think of this region And even Chengdu, the southwest of China, over the years, many of us have been witnessing, a very large exhibition at Chengdu and even the Kunming, the Yunnan province. Sichuan and Yunnan have been the basis for the southwest of China, and they are mostly catering the south eastern Asian market. So now they're becoming the hub for, the imports from these regions. So Chengdu has always been a very lucrative market for handicraft, and please take this very seriously. And China, China itself, if we see, so we don't need to think for the rest of the world. China itself is such a lucrative market for handicraft that even if we, pitch each and every province of this country, this is enough for us for the next 10 years, inshallah. I have a question in advance so that, our keynote speakers from Chengdu and Gangzhou can have some few words over that. First of all, I'd like to raise the issue of geographical indicators. We recently had, the parliamentary legislation over this issue, and I congratulate our parliament and even all, the Ministry of Commerce for initiating this issue. So how can we implement this over, our handicraft products, the geographical indication? Secondly, we've had a recent free trade agreement with China as well. So have we been able to, totally, utilize this agreement? We have to make it to our own benefit rather than just letting, the other side getting the benefit out of this. So this is all from my side. I wish all the best and good luck to all the participants. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Fahad Saab. So the main purpose of this webinar is to, explore market opportunities in the Chinese market. And this time we have the Chengdu region in focus. So we are honored to have Acting Consul General Chengdu with us, Mr. Mahmood Akhtar. And now I would like to invite him to, give his brief and overview of the Chinese market. Sir, over to you. Sir, I've made you co-host, so you may share any presentation that you want to.
I should use share screen?
Yes, sir, you can share screen.
Is this visible? The share screen is visible?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to talk about a very, very important sector of handicrafts, especially I'll be focusing on the area in the consular districts. And I will be just briefly telling the importance in economic sense of the area, and then each consular district and province, and then I'll be going to show the position of our trade with the region, and then specifically going to the recommendations and portions that help and practical handicrafts area. So it's the latest one consulate established in 2007, and we have four areas: Sichuan, Yunnan, Guizhou, and Chongqing municipality. And its area is 1.1 million, and that is about 20-30% more than Pakistan. And population is about 213 million, almost equal to Pakistan. GDP is about 1.16 trillion, larger than many European countries. And it is very important home to Chinese state of owned enterprises investing in Pakistan, energy, transport, and other sectors. As a result of CPEC and Obor region, it is very important region to Pakistan because it is the most Han Chinese, the most developed city in this region. And even from China-Pakistan economic corridor point of view, many, many projects, central locations are in this area. and Europe and Southeast Asian countries have special presence in the region. Then Sichuan province, 486 kilometers, 92 million population, and the 2019 GDP is $686 billion. That is almost 2.5 times of Pakistan. And it is very special area from food and grains, part of Nepal, China's domestic food security. And it is very important for China's Western development strategy and Chongqing Chengdu development in India. And Chengdu, the city in which we have our consulate, it is the fourth largest city in China. Its population is around 17 million, perhaps another one city is equal to this population in Pakistan. It's the city's GDP in 2019 was $250 billion, and this year the growth rate was one of the highest in the whole of China, 86. So that has not been shown to that. That almost becomes equal to the whole of Pakistan's GDP. And there were 31,000 expatriates, but after COVID, the number is less. And out of 500 Fortune companies, 352 companies have presence in this city. It produces 20% of world's computers and 70% of iPads. They are produced in this city. And it is very important automobile manufacturing hub in China. And the most important and exciting thing about this area is that the train to Europe leaves from this city. And that is treated as a special export zone. And I'll be mentioning later that soon, inshallah, we are going to have a Pakistan pavilion in that special zone. Then Yunnan province. Yunnan province is 94,000 square kilometers. Population is 48 million. GDP was 342 billion in 2019. That is more than Pakistan. ASEAN countries are neighboring. And this becomes very important from the handicrafts point of view, that every year in June, the Kunming Expo is held. And that last year, more than 200 Pakistani exhibitors participated, and they're overwhelmingly, more than 70% are in handicrafts and related products within that. Tomorrow it is going to be opening ceremony. Our special secretary of Congress, Mr. Speaker, will be leading the message from Pakistan is that, and around 40 to 50 companies have already registered on now. And the majority are in the traditional handicrafts and the Pakistani leather jacket, shoes, handmade things. So from that point of view, in whole of China, if any exclusive item from Pakistan in handicrafts is related, that was a Kunming. Unfortunately, it couldn't happen this year. Online session starts tomorrow. Then is Guizhou. It is very little presence for Pakistan. It's basically tourists. But even then, its GDP was $106 billion, population 40 million. And the big data companies are having storing their data in there because the clean energy sources are very rich in this Guizhou province. But it is basically tourism, and usually it is considered to be one of the poorest countries, the provinces in China. But already this year, just last month, government of China has announced that it completely eliminated poverty in China, and that many major areas of those counties are improved. So this is this area which shows, just to give you a background, that we are talking about an area whose 7% of total GDP of China, that will become about $1.5 trillion. That is about 6 to 7 times of Pakistan. And connectivity and DRA is very important. And from defense point of view, Western theater commands. In Pakistan, we have defense corps, but this is very advanced idea where the theater is used. And Western theater command is based in Chengdu, and that also gives you India and Pakistan area, and 7 countries, almost half of that area. So from defense point of view, it also becomes very important that the economy is there. But from defense point of view, when you connect it to that idea, then it shows that this is very, very important. So now, after this brief background, see the trade relations. Trade figures we obviously can see the 4 years and up to quarter two. Unfortunately, you see, there were imports always rising. That they almost 8 times increase in 2019. This year, pandemic, they are unsure reality. And exports from Pakistan in 2019, perhaps till now, was one of the best. They almost 2.5 times, 19.29 from 8.097. And this one item which has missing is always usually in Kunming, usually people make on spot sales. Technically, that is not, but for Pakistan, it comes from Pakistan. But this is the data of customs. So, from handicrafts point of view, that Kunming is one, and another event is going to happen in Sichuan in January. But this year, no one is going to participate from Pakistan. That I will discuss separately. So, from here, we can see that there is the capacity. That if it was 8 million in 2017, then in 2019, it became 19 million. But quarter one, we have figures up to second quarter only, it is 5.4. It is still around 25 or 30% of 2019 figures. But even we compare with 2017, it is still 60 or 70%. It shows that the consistency of trade has increased. But the imports items for China from Pakistan and Pakistani exports, they were chromium, cotton yarn, rice, all other animal produce and frozen seafood. The here our target is the handicrafts. In this, I will give a personal example. They are written raw leather. That there is a brand Sherme, that's a Chinese traditional shoes brand. Their minimum shoe price is $300 and reaches up to $3,000. The lady told me that she has visited Sialkot and she knew and bought leather because the quality of leather is very good. And in Kunming Expo, the Pakistani handmade leather jackets are given there and people like them. Some people, if they come from Tibet, because Kunming is an area which is called Spring City and there is almost no winter. The temperature remains hovers around 20 in the city. But in far-flung areas, they are very cold. And some people told me last year that there is very good demand for Pakistani handmade leather jackets. Especially the people who come from Tibet, Chiang Rai, that's very, very cold. And even the average height is about 3,000 to 4,000 meters above the sea level. That's very high. And from that area, this most important thing is handmade leather jackets and even bags. They are very popular in Kunming Expo. This is Expo, the same is repeated with the further details. Breakdown. So from that you can say that maximum has been in Sichuan, but last year it was Chongqing. The reason is rice and seafood, they were due to the quota. So we have been participating in these shows, FPCCI, TDAP, KCCI, APFP in China, South Asia Expo, in Kunming, New Year Shopping Festival in Chengdu. Others are technical, but these two are very important from Pakistan's point of view, especially from handicrafts. That in Kunming, as I told, 200. But in New Year Shopping Festival, there is a private person who hires them, brings the people. Last year, there were around 40 people or 50 people from there. So, and TDAP is not participating in this festival, shopping festival, and it runs for 3 weeks. And majority of the people go there and buy the things. Last year, we were there. There were some problems about the quality and the things. The TDAP should be actively participating from handicrafts further in this Chengdu New Year Shopping Festival. Unfortunately, this year they are not following the people from Pakistan. So this was the background. That the area is huge. I sum up 1.5 million trillion. Population is almost equal to Pakistan. And it is per capita income is increasing size. And due to Kunming and Chengdu, our handicrafts have already presence in this area. So now I will be just focusing on that. How can we practically implement the ideas to enhance our handicrafts? I have just chosen very specific examples. Provide samples for display in Pakistan pavilions. There are One pavilion is in Kunming, and second is going to be soon to be inaugurated in Qinpaijian. It is under construction. As a matter of fact, I'll be visiting that on 15th of December. And they were asking for decoration. I have asked many times to people that it is for you. You can put your card and the company brochure and at least give some things. But no exhibitor has shown interest. I personally talked to them. No one has shown. So that is very important. They will be permanent pavilions. One is in Kunming Exhibition Center. And second one is in Chengdu. So the items would be with your own logos and with your own contacts, which are your flagship products to be shown in that. This is a practical thing which you can do. And second idea is establishment of display centers in major cities, CBDs and tourist areas. Now the Chinese people have become so curious to buy and unique items. For example, in Chengdu, the area is called Thaikuli. It is the hub of tourist area. And every night you go, thousands of people come there. 80% people are from outside. There is one Kwanzaa Alley that is almost a handicraft. So in that, of course, not a single company, TDAP, Ministry of Commerce, and the associations should make permanently, just hire a person, take some space. On non-attractive places, we can assure that they are ready to give it free of cost. But to bring people to that place is only possible when you arrange a meeting. Otherwise, they are not attractive. But if they are in tourist areas and CBDs, then it is sure shot that those items will be bought by the tourists. And another third point, which I always ask the exhibitors, and they never do, unfortunately. Regularly provide samples to consulates for using as souvenirs and display in the consulate room. I have no pictures. I could show. I have added someone with my own efforts. I have asked many times, but no exhibitor or no association sends us anything to show. And this is a fact. I have tried 3, 4, 5 times, and no one brings it. And then most important thing is provide materials in Chinese language. We got from TDAF some very small things, digital versions, but provide the brochures in Chinese language. It is going to increase your cost, certainly, but that is going to enhance your market score. Because usually Chinese, so in some way establish a stall from consulate with material in Chinese, and we don't have it in Chinese, but in English. They always ask, have you got it in Chinese? Because maybe very little people can understand English language. But the Chinese, it is their major language. So it will enhance multiple the trade opportunities, especially for handicrafts. And the fifth point is develop a dedicated websites in Chinese dealing with handicraft sectors. Why I'm saying this, I give you an example. I was previously in Shanghai. So in 2000 early, due to child labor, our carpets got banned. Then the Iranian carpets came and they occupied the market. At that time, 20 years ago, China was getting rich. Unfortunately, due to that child labor issue, our carpets were not there. Even many Pakistanis were selling, oh, this is Iranian carpet. Because the understanding of Chinese people was that the best carpets which they had seen came from Iran. I show in my home, I have some carpets which I got from Balochistan, the nation. They're amazing. And people don't know that they are made in Pakistan, in Balochistan area and our Kashmir area. And in our consulate, we have put a very big gauj from Sindh as a display on a wall. I tell them people especially, and it's very fascinating for them. So we are trying that idea that at least if we get small pieces for display, many people come, we can give it to them. And the website in Chinese, we welcome. We have developed a QR code related to the trade and tourism. In that, we can put your material without any problem. We pay it regularly for every year. That's a QR code. You scan it. Then in that, you can find videos and material about Pakistan. Anyone who's interested can contact me and send material. We will put their companies of no interest except to promote Pakistan. That you can send the price list of brochures. And we usually put that QR code on our Weibo website. Then people can scan it and can see it. And you can put your contacts that they can be directly in contact with you. that is very, very effective tool within the Chinese system. That now I have rarely received a call from any Chinese on mobile or a landline. They use WeChat. And WeChat just simply scans the code. And you will reach to a world where you can find people that what is the product of the video. Now it is very important, especially in COVID aspects. And that special marketing and holistic to approach to engage with buyers, associations, public sectors, and exhibition companies in China. The whole exhibition companies are there, and there are the professional people who run exhibitions, who develop your marketing plans within Chinese market, of course. So associations, and then you should join them. They can make a whole plan that instead, of course, our resources in consulates and TDEF can be limited. We don't understand the market. But utilizing those marketing specialized companies, the association and TDEF can communicate and sell their products. I give you that how it is going to work. For example, just on the second building to our office is Hilton Hotel. So in Hilton Hotel, they have one restaurant, its name is Onyx, O-N-Y-X, Onyx. So I was talking to them, the idea that Onyx material from Pakistan comes, and we have very good handicrafts. So my idea is that if we get a good piece, then we can convince the hotel person that please just put it there as a gift. The name is Onyx, and I'm trying to know that if they have Onyx in every Hilton, then association and TDEC should engage with Onyx at the Hilton group that please put our these products free of cost, just put them there. It's a very high star, 5-star hotel, and that idea is there. We need things. I have very small pieces, but we need a big piece. We can convince them, they'll be ready. They showed, I talked to them informally, they said, we are ready to put in our Onyx, and it is just you enter, it is in the lobby. So it is a very, very good idea, practical idea that you need to put it, just give us a thing. We are here to put it there. You can put it from association, just put a code there, people can use it. That's very important in Chinese market. And very important part, it will be my last point from the recommendation point of view, the Chinese market is very sensitive from price point of view. This is not due to increasing GDP difference or not, it is their historical culture. I give its example that porcelain or Chinese porcelain started from China. Since 2000 years, they had 3 to 4 types of porcelain. One was sold to only kings, that only the kings and the governments were allowed to buy. Second was for ministers and very rich businessmen. And third was for personal use, to keep it in your home. And fourth was for general users in restaurants. And the same model works in China. iPhone, just like 8 or 1,000 US dollar is made in this country. And you can get a mobile phone for 50 US dollars. And it works with all functions of a smartphone. So you have to understand the Chinese market. Now the problems come in that our handicrafts come, their quality is very low. For example, in north and northeast of China, people are rich. Their GDP as compared to this area, purchasing power is 3 times more. So they can buy rich quality. Unfortunately, the same person, the same exhibitor, if he's in northeast, he's selling that item for example, 500 RMB. And the same item he'll be selling there in Chengdu or Kunming in 100 RMB. So for that, if someone gets connected and the quality, for that, price and quality, you have to develop the tiers. And this, if it is the time, if you don't act upon this idea, our quality will get a bad name. The reason being that now Chinese are growing, their purchasing power is more. For that, we need standardization from Pakistan. It's a very good idea that TDEF and Commerce Ministry have started. Also put the standards. Simple, A product, B product, C product. And give you that. The owner of my building in which we have consulate, he asked me personally that if can consulate can recommend some handicrafts. It's a big group, Thungwe Group. It's one of the big companies dealing with agriculture products. photovoltaic cells. They say, we will buy, if you recommend, we will buy handicrafts and utilize it for company and to give us gifts. But consulate must recommend. For that, I cannot recommend a product that is a very low quality. They will give money, very good money, and perhaps they can be permanent buyer. But for that, we need quality. And you can make tiers. Yes, some areas cannot afford the money. Give them the lower price. So this is very important that we develop a quality standards catering to the local market. So from this, on this point, I will finish my presentation. When you have a question and answer any specific, you're welcome to ask. Thank you very much for teed up, especially Ahmed Hassan. I talked to him on the phone that we would love to talk about this and all other participants and associations. It's a very good opportunity to talk about practical needs. Thank you very much. Over to you, Ahmed Hassan.
Thank you very much, sir, for this list of very cogent and very effective recommendations that you've given from the side of Chengdu. So before we move on to the interactive session, we have Mr. Mohammed Irfan, who is Trade and Investment Counselor, Guangzhou. So we will first ask him to talk about the Guangzhou region, and then we will move on to the interactive session when participants will be able to give their questions onwards. So now I will give the floor to Mr. Mohammed Irfan, sir. The floor is yours.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Thank you very much, Ahmed. Assalamu alaikum, Akhtar Saab, and everybody who is sitting in this webinar. Ahmed, I would like to share my screen.
I've made you co-host, sir, so you can share your screen now.
Okay. Okay. This is the webinar is about handicrafts market analysis of Southern China region, which I'm looking after. You people have already listened from Beijing, Shanghai, and now Chengdu. And this is the fourth important part of this whole series of webinars. So, now, something about introduction. For China, as everybody knows, this is the third largest population-wise country, having 1.42 billion population, and this have 34 provincial level administrative units. Beijing is capital, and commercial section Guangzhou is the region who is looking after this Fujian, Guangdong, Hainan, Hunan, and autonomous region of Guangxi and Zhejiang. This is five provinces we are looking after. Its total economy of these five regions is 19.47 trillion yuan. This is total share in Chinese economies of this region has around 20%. Major industries in this region is electronics, machinery, petrochemical, textiles, construction materials, pharmaceuticals, automobiles, and motorcycles. Its exports is 829 billion and imports are $563 billion. Major seaports, it has Guangzhou, Shenzhen, Guangxi, there are all the major important cities have their ports, their airports are with the big airports are available in this major brand in this area is Huawei, Tencent, Media, and many other names. It has special economic zones in Shenzhen, Zhuhai, Xiamen and Hainan. Now, handicraft industry of the region, the global handicraft market is $526 billion in 2017, and in 2019 it has grown to $663 billion. The market value is projected in 2023 around $984 billion. Handicraft markets overall in China, China's folk handicraft industry has been rapidly improving. Market size is continuously growing. Data shows that in 2015, China's folk handicraft industry market size was about $87 billion. And in 2020, this has reached to $153 billion. This is market analysis for the China's imports from Pakistan and China's Pakistan's export to the world and China's imports from the world. If we look at these, HS codes 74 copper and article, these are all those HS codes which are in which these handicrafts are considered. Raw hides, you can see from this presentation, I would leave you for you people to analyze on this, you can have this presentation. But the share of the major important point in this is the share of Pakistan's exports in China's imports. Overall, we have less than 1% share in total imports of China, but in the handicrafts, we have even less than 1% share in few sectors. These are wooden articles, ceramics, miscellaneous articles. So we have a very, very meager share in these. We have $128,000 imports in 2017. And if we consider about wood and articles, when we the furniture and handmade furniture are evaluated. So you can see in 2017, 18, 19, our share is almost minor increase in these shares. 128,000 was 2017, and 2018 it is on just $135,000 and $195,000. So its share is not as we should expect from Pakistan's point of view. But this share is in the world. China's imports are increasing, but Pakistan's share is almost stagnant. You see, in other ceramics products, we are not available in this market. So these are, basic. Then China, South China region, domestic handicraft enterprises are mainly distributed in Jiangsu and Zhejiang regions. South China and Central China, data shows that number of four. China itself is one of the largest handicraft exporters in the world, having to 30% share in total exports. India is the second largest and followed by Vietnam. And itself, whatever world is producing, China is also copying that and producing that. So margin of the indigenous products is not much higher in this region, but still, this is if we analyze this trade statistics of our region, crafts of wood. This is we have largest share in this market of our handicrafts. This is for major camel skins, leather goods in Peshawari, chapal, khusa, and knotted carpets and rugs. These are four, five major products which we have in which we have presence in this region. But the share, if we consider the total increase in these products, we have increase in craft and woods in this region, but we have decline in Himalayan salts, crystal lamps. We have a huge decline in this. Leather goods, we can see that there is in 2019, there's a sharp decline in this exports as well. And article of leather, travel goods, handbags, this also has been. This is as compared to 2018, it has a decline in 2019. What do you consider the footwear as compared to 2018? There is also a decline in the carpet and other textile flooring. There is a sharp decline in 2017. We have $53,000 exports, and which has been reduced to $35,000 in 2018. And this is only $3,617 in 2019. Situation is very alarming. Now, what are the problems for declining our exports? 2019 is a special year for the corona, but before 2020, 2019 was also not a good year for Pakistan's exports of handicraft products in this region. COVID-19, this is one of the reasons consumer is not willing to spend money. Indian handicraft exports also declines more than 40% during this year. Pakistan's exports are also declining in these sectors, but overall Pakistan's exports are improving in this region. Then high shipping charges, no free movement of people in China, visa restrictions, flights not available, and quarantine requirements. Mostly exhibitions have been postponed or shifted to online mode. China itself is the largest exporter of handicrafts, as I earlier told you. Now, what is way forward with this? How we can tackle the situation of negative trend in our exports of handicrafts in China? The most important sector, as my senior Mahmoud Saab has told you about, the e-commerce and online businesses. China is mostly relying on online retails and e-commerce channels. This has provided a boost to the sales of handicraft goods across the globe, but still Pakistan's presence in this online retail stores is I have not seen not a single Pakistani exporter has links with this online stores. I have not seen in this region. And then another is designing of the products. The designs of Pakistani products are, there is no much improvement on those designs. They are working on, the same designs again and again, but the world has changed now. People are, very much enthusiastic about the new designs and new things. But this Pakistani, they need to work on designs of these products. We are not focusing on tourism industry. Of course, Pakistan's tourism industry has a lot of potentials, but this is not very well tapped tourism industry in the whole of the world, Pakistan. Our products are all not so are not also focusing on tourists as well. Then cultural always plays important role. Designs should be in alignment with Chinese culture. Our recommendation, in addition to Sir Akhtar, this is, every product, I've seen a number of exhibitions that exhibitors bring their products and they try to sell those products on spot, but without, telling people about much of the description about the products. And secondly, the product is made by someone else and, the selling guys are someone else. So they might have no proper information about their product, their worth of those product. So it is always better if handmade products have a small description about the product, why they have conceived the idea of building that product. That is very important. And that must be in Chinese language so that, people can understand. And then, detailed description gives your customer more confidence in the product. Thirdly is to keep consistent. Consistency is very important. Our exhibitors, they are not consistent in one market. They come for an exhibition for 1 year and next year they are disappeared. So they only come for, selling. That is very, in my personal experience, I have seen in one of the exhibitions in Germany that one Indian exporter, I visited that exhibition in 2008 and then I visited in 2019. So that exhibitor was on that same spot in 2018 and in 2019. So 11 years he was consistently displaying his goods in that exhibition on the same spot. So that consistency is very important. In our case, neither TDAP is consistent in participating in exhibitions, not the exhibitor is consistent in participating in same exhibition a number of years. So they come in exhibition, they sell goods. If it's going well, they will try to come next year. If it does not go well, and they will disappear. Then the packaging of the China is very unique market. They see what kind of packaging they have made, what they have written on the packaging, and what material they have used in the packaging. So we are what I have seen that we are not very much on these packaging things. Then as earlier told you, the social media, this is very important. Every Chinese user on every day spend almost 2 hours on social media. They like to browse, they like to see stores, and they like to get ideas from there, and then they buy it. If they have seen some product on social media, they might, when they go to the exhibition, they might they might buy, they might, you know, they might get interested in that product. Then as, you know, this you have already listened that give free samples if possible. That is very important. Building a relationship with the customer, with the client is very important. We are, you know, we have an idea that our exporter is not, you know, maybe not so rich in that sense that he can afford these free samples, but small souvenirs with the low cost, that can work in this. Then, you know, importance of building brands. We are nowhere in brands, neither in handicrafts nor in the bigger products. We are nowhere in the brands. Now in Pakistani, some Pakistani, you know, in gems and jewelry, I've seen some Pakistanis are working on building brands. Like we have displayed one in recently we had an exhibition in Nanning, and one of Pakistani exhibitors has a very good brand in the name of Vinza. So they are displaying their products in Shanghai as well, and all those exhibitions which are related to the, you know, this handicrafts and gems and jewelry. So he's getting good response in this market. Then traditional Chinese characters, you know, the Chinese are, you know, they love their culture. So if this is just an example, if a tea set is made from onyx and handicrafts with traditional Chinese character on it, is more eye-catching than the normal one. So this is just a hint of how you can present your product in Chinese market. Then there are some opportunities. We have a free trade agreement with China. Mostly items are duty-free. Whatever you have, handicraft items are almost duty-free in this market. And, you know, the mostly the Chinese, you know, the problems what we are facing a few years ago, even last year, this was high duty, around 32% was the duty structure on this. And now this is duty as zero duty rated. And of course, this year we were expecting a jump in our exports in China, but unfortunately due to COVID-19 situations, we could not get that jump. So all the exporters should get benefit from this FTA between China and Pakistan. Then, of course, we are close friends to China, and Chinese, you know, have a very soft heart towards Pakistani. They get special treatment in China nowadays. Like we are, you know, special partner country status we got in Guangxi this year, and we have special partner country status in Guangxi, Nanning for next year as well. So this special partner status, you know, they we receive a huge response from this Guangxi region. A lot of, you know, city branding we received, and a lot of visitors visited Pakistan's exhibitors, and they were very satisfied and very happy. As I earlier told, that duty structure is zero only. You have to pay a VAT 13%. Chinese customers love Pakistani wooden furniture. It is handmade and made of Pakistani rosewood, and it has a good response in Nanning and Shanghai. So people who are working in this sector, they can capitalize this situation in China nowadays. Of course, if you are working with China, you know, this is general guidelines of mass retailers, but our product, the handicraft products, seldom find some mass retailers and departmental stores. We are mostly focusing on specialty stores and independent retailers and online stores. These are three major our sourcing channels. Then exhibitions are very important for spot selling and introducing our products. Then there's permanent country pavilions. We are establishing permanent country pavilions in Nanning, and we have already formalized all the details. And in near future, we are going to open that permanent country pavilion of Pakistan in that product. And we were going to link this permanent country pavilion with e-commerce gateways. And do we have agreement with them? They will be marketing Pakistani products on online on just small percentage basis. So now exhibitors, you know, the Pakistani businessmen is not, you know, that they have an opportunity. They can display their products in our permanent country pavilion, and we can link up them with this online sellers. And this will be a unique opportunity in the southern China region. This is the this will be the first permanent country pavilion in this region. And in Guangzhou, we are also establishing one permanent country pavilion. We have established a new office here because this is a newly opened office in Guangzhou in this year. And we have our office and we have a display center there as well. So I would suggest whoever is interested, we can display his products here and we can link up all the visitors to you directly. Then there's some important exhibitions we are going to organize in this region. This is Canton Fair. Everyone knows this fair. This is very important, one of the world's largest fair. This year, Canton Fair held online, but next year we are expecting this will be a physical show. And we are in contact with the Canton Fair organization so that they can provide Pakistan a subsidized pavilion over there as well. Then there is very important Xiamen Handicraft Fair. This will be held in May. So most of the people should join this exhibition as well. Then this Guangzhou International Handicraft Expo in Guangzhou. We are trying to get special treatment in this fair as well. And we are trying to get subsidized stalls in this fair for Pakistani handicraft exporters. Then this Ka Expo, China ASEAN Expo in Nanning. This year we were special partner country, and next year we are also special partner country. TDAP will be organizing this exhibition, and I suggest everybody to come in this exhibition as well. This is we have recently received a very good response in this exhibition, and I'm expecting because we are establishing a free display center over there. So for permanent presence of Pakistani handicraft products in this region, this is I would suggest everybody to participate in this exhibition. Then this is in Haikou. This is another very important region in this southern China, and is a very rich in sense. And people are, there is a China International Consumer Product, and some people are participating in this exhibition as well. And next year, I would suggest that more and more people should participate in this exhibition. These are focused handicraft products. It's onyx and marbles, wooden handicrafts, hanging carpets, brass and aluminum products, leather goods, and footwear. This is the focused products. We suggest the people who are dealing with these products, they have a good scope in this market. Thank you very much. This was my presentation, and I'm open for any questions, any comments. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much, sir, for this very comprehensive presentation on the handicraft market opportunities for handicraft in the Guangzhou region. So now I will open the floor for the interactive session, and I would ask the participants to please raise their hands if they have questions. And unless they specify, I will request both Sir Irfan and Sir Mahmood Akhtar to please answer their questions. So to begin with, we have Ms. Masuma Sipten, who has been with us in this webinar series for since the beginning, and she's chairperson of Women Economic Reforms Committee. So ma'am, I will give the floor to you.
Assalamu alaikum, and thank you very much for such comprehensive series of webinars from TDAP. और यहाँ मैं बहुत अप्रिशिएट करूँगी आप लोगों की एफर्ट को कि आप लोगों ने जिस तरह से पूरे चाइना के सारे कमर्शियल सेक्शंस को दे ऑल आर हियर एंड द टीडैप इज प्लेइंग द रोल दे शुड बी प्लेड और जिसको मतलब हम लोग ख्वाहिश करते थे क्योंकि जब तक आपके कमर्शियल सेक्शंस और आपके प्राइवेट पब्लिक सेक्टर आर ऑन वन बोर्ड एंड दिस इज कंटिन्यूस एफर्ट और we are really thankful and really we are really sure ke hum log through our we can say handicrafts we will be able to promote our tourism culture and rest of the trade too because what I believe is that the handicraft of any country shows their culture their diversity and their positiveness aur pakistan ke to aap karachi se lekar aur ab we have now fifth प्रोविंस गिलगित बल्तिस्तान जहाँ चले जाते हैं वहाँ का बहुत खूबसूरत और ऐसा हैंडीक्राफ्ट है कि जो जिसकी बहुत ज्यादा वी कैन से हिस्ट्री है एंड इट्स टेल्स इट्स ओन स्टोरीज हेयर आई हैव सम क्वेरीज, क्योंकि मैं ये अपनी तरफ से बात नहीं करूंगी, क्योंकि आपके इन हैंडीक्राफ्ट्स के ऊपर हमारे पास नेशनली पूरे पाकिस्तान से, क्योंकि वी हैव वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग लिंक्स, तो डिस्कशंस और बातें मुख्तलिफ होती रही हैं। तो जिसमें एक सबसे पहली जो थी लेडीज ने, पहले भी मैंने आपको रिक्वेस्ट की थी कि आपके जो भी ये, क्योंकि इट्स एन एफर्ट, और एक तो ये कि हमें वन पेजर आपको रिक्वेस्ट की थी हमने कि जो भी सारी डिटेल्स हैं उनको एक सिंपलीफाइड फॉर्म में एक पेज अगर हमें ये लोग डेवलप्ड कर देते हैं, सो इट विल बी हैवी, मतलब जो बहुत सारे लोग जो ये वेबिनार्स अटेंड भी नहीं कर सकते, वी कैन सर्कुलेट विद देम। और दूसरा मुझे थोड़ा सा ये बताएं कि हमारी जैसे मुल्तान वुमेन चैम्बर, आई एम फ्रॉम सदरन पंजाब, कि मोस्ट ऑफ द वुमेन आर इन टेक्सटाइल सेक्टर, लाइक हैंड एम्ब्रॉयडर्ड एंड एवरीथिंग, तो इसमें हमें थोड़ी सी जो गाइडेंस चाहिए होगी वो इस तरह से चाहिए होगी कि दे प्रिपेयर देयर ओन प्रोडक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू वी कैन से कि देयर ओन डायस्पोरा। तो अगर हम उसके अंदर हमें वहां से कोई ऐसा फैशन कंसल्टेंट या ऐसे लोग, क्योंकि ब्यूटिफुल हैंडमेड एम्ब्रॉयडरी कैन बी शिप, और जिसमें वी हैव लाइक वी कैन से प्रोडक्ट फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर पाकिस्तान, कि जिसमें हमें थोड़ी सी अगर इनको प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट के अंदर हेल्प कर देते हैं तो दे कैन मतलब प्ले अ वेरी गुड रोल इन टर्म ऑफ वी कैन से एक्सपोर्ट्स एंड एवरीथिंग। सो अभी इतनी बात करते हैं, फिर चलें मुझे इन्हीं दो तीन क्वेरीज का बता दें जी। थैंक यू वेरी मच
जी।
सर वुड यू लाइक टू रिस्पोंड और शुड आई मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन?
नो, वी कैन रिस्पोंड इट, देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम।
Yes, sir.
Thank you. It's a really relevant question है product development के हवाले से। तो हमने ये एक project शुरू किया था इस्लामाबाद में, आप लोग देख रहे हैं TDP इस्लामाबाद में, ये जो product development hub है, I think people from product development hub are also sitting there. So the purpose was to develop products according to the needs and culture of the target market. सो इस पे जो टी डी ए पी का रोल है वो बड़ा इम्पॉर्टेंट है। टी डी ए पी को इसमें जो चाइनीज़ कल्चर और उसको मद्देनजर रखते हुए ये गाइडेंस प्रोवाइड करनी चाहिए। हम अपनी तरफ से जो भी कोई असिस्टेंस आपको चाहिए वी आर रेडी टू प्रोवाइड यू, बट हायरिंग ऑफ फैशन कंसल्टेंट इज द जॉब ऑफ यू नो इट्स अ प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट थिंग। सो आप अगर उस पर टी डी ए पी इस पर फोकस करें तो ये ज़्यादा अच्छा होगा एज कम्पेयर टू यू नो वेयर वी आर सिटिंग एज अ कमर्शियल कॉन्स्टेबल हेयर। बाकी जो इनको यहाँ पे मार्केटिंग के हवाले से कोई भी प्रॉब्लम्स हैं इनकी प्रोडक्ट्स की, कुछ स्पेसिफिक नीड्स हैं, तो वी आर रेडी टू यू नो हेल्प देम आउट। सो ये एक तो ये बात होगी। तो प्रोडक्ट डेवलपमेंट वाले यहाँ बैठे हुए हैं तो आई होप दे कैन रिस्पॉन्ड ऑन इट। आई डोंट नो, टू इयर्स अगो वी स्टार्टेड दिस प्रोजेक्ट एंड दे आर वेरी यू नो एक्टिव पीपल, तो आई होप दे हैव डन अ वेरी गुड जॉब ऑन दिस। थैंक यू। Ahmed, thank you. Next question, you can take next question.
Yes, Sir Mahmood, would you like to add something to this?
For the designing, that's a very good idea. And now there are some companies that are using traditional combinations. So if they have some specific need, there are some companies that are concerned there, we can connect it to them. They can learn from the designing and how it can be helpful for them to improve their designing. Understand that there are some private companies, some are dealing with designing doing the silk, and some are doing in the traditional Chinese material. So they can contact us with their exact requirement and need, and we will connect them to the relevant people. No problem. That's a very good idea so that they can improve and synergize their designing or the modeling, especially in the textile.
Thank you very much, sir. I would also like to add that we will have a second round of matchmaking webinars with the same mission. So I do request all of our suppliers here to please share detailed product catalogs of their products so that the missions there can then engage in finding buyers for their products, so that in our second round of webinars, we can have actual export orders and we could have some concrete results out of this. So now we have Ms. Naima Ansari who has a question, so I will give the floor to her.
Just mentioned. So I would just like to say that we're already developing product for women entrepreneurs according to international market. And here's just a suggestion. If Product Development Hub and TDAP can, let's say, contact this Chinese Cultural Center in Pakistan embassy, and they do invite certain craftsmen or skilled oriented people to Pakistan. If we do that, because we do have a product, but according to Chinese taste and, you know, converting handicraft into consumer product is the biggest challenge that we Pakistani face right now. If we have a handicraft and if it's not, let's say, properly converted into a consumer oriented product, we might not get orders. So as of right now, this is what we all need to understand, that, okay, handicraft is one thing, but is that handicraft appropriate according to the international standard? Is that handicraft perfectly converted into a consumable product? Consumable product, I mean like converting the handicraft into fashion accessories. It could be one. So I think today I will contact with someone in TDAP here in Islamabad with the DG Saab, and we will initiate this with the Chinese embassy in Pakistan. Because they already have resources for that. I mean, they do invite Chinese craft people, or let's say in any scale. So why not utilize them? Thank you so much.
Sir Irfan, would you like to respond?
Naima has raised a point regarding inviting a Chinese cultural office in present in Islamabad, I think. I'm not wrong. So it's a TDAP, you can invite them and link them with this product development hub. They have very good facility, and they can actually guide, because this project was an EDF funded project, and this project was designed for this particular purpose, making the products according to the needs of next target market. So if anything needed from China, so you can specifically write to us, and we can always available for to coordinate and to help you people out. Thank you.
I will move on to the next question. Then we have one from Late Starfish Vlogs. So I will give the floor to them. I think they have a question specifically for the Chinese market.
Hello, Assalamu Alaikum. This is Sanam Habibullah from Indus Civilization. Sir, I have been running this company since 2 years, and I'm purely dealing with the products of interior sin, the cultural things, ajraks, and all such natural dyes and stuff. So recently I have joined your sessions, and I was trying to follow your steps, as you said that how we can, you know, try on Alibaba and all the such, you know, websites which can give us the access to the Chinese. So I was thinking that better the already products which they have, and the similar products we can try there. The fee to join it, like, it's too much for the starters, like the people who are starting up like us since like 2 years we are into the business. So when we already for the trial of business, that either they will buy our products or not, and whatever product they need, we can, you know, directly go to the market and apply 1 lakh or something amount just to register and, you know, try for 1 year. So we try to reach the customer. From as you know, business, we try to reach the customer and get few orders. But if we compare our prices after shipment to the Chinese market product prices, already they have everything. Like the ajrak is also coming in the machine made ajraks. So when they come to us to buy the ajraks from us, already the original ajrak is, you know, pricing so much high than as compared to the machine made ajrak, which they have already in their market. And then the shipments. So someone who wants to buy ajraks from us in a limited quantity or either just for a trial, or we can say that they want to have the samples. So it cost a lot to us as well and to them as well. So even in India, their handicrafts, they are ready to send us. And I don't know how they can reach every market so easily. Even there is the people who are starting up there, they are ready to send their samples even to us. So I request the government and people like you who are you know, at such levels to think that to help us send our samples first, and it should be cheaper for us so that they can check our samples and then they can get orders, and then they can, we can come to the level that we can go for, you know, higher shipments, and we can get the orders to send the containers or 50 kg and you know, hundreds of kgs of stuff. First, please help us in the initial stage, like the step where we are. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir, would you like to respond?
Lady has 2 points, actually. Number one is the cost of registering on Alibaba, and second is sending samples you know, abroad, and they have cost. So number one is regarding registration with Alibaba. And in my presentation, I told you that we are in contact with some other online stores, which are working on you know, on you know, consumer to consumer basis. And we are also making some permanent display centers in Guangzhou, as well as in Chengdu, Sarakhtar has told you. So these permanent display centers, the basic purpose is this: you can display your product over there, you can put your sample over there, and those samples are readily available. So use one time cost, you can send, even you can, we will have involve TDAP to send those samples. So those samples, if you are, you have permanent display center here and your product is safe here, and you can easily tell your customer, your clients, they can visit those stores and they can have visit of your product. Now, the concept of those permanent display centers, which we have conceived, is we are linking those permanent display centers with online stores. Those online e-commerce gateways, they have MOU with us, and they will be marketing our products online as well. So they will be charging only 4-5% of their total sales, whatever their services charges, not. And we are getting these spaces as free of cost as well. So this will be no burden on an exporter. We are linking you people with the TDAP and with the commercial sections. We will be bridge between the, between you people, and TDAP will be sending those samples. So whenever we will of course you know, circulate this information through media that you people can contact to TDAP for sending these your samples abroad, and of course that will be the government expenditures. So we are trying to reduce the burdens of exporters. We know the difficulties, and that's why we are working on different ideas. So I hope this establishment of permanent display centers and sending their samples to TDAP, and those samples will always be available in this market. I think it will serve the purpose, and it can solve the problem what you people are facing. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for providing this very valuable insight, sir. I would also request Sir Mahmood Akhtar if he has anything to add to this particular aspect.
In relevant to these all making display centers, all that is most important question is that we must understand that the Chinese market is entirely different from the traditional. It's an emerging market in Europe, in USA, Middle East, people know it. And the lady has rightly pointed out that the ajrak is machine made. Here you have to talk about your product being unique and original and handmade. And it has a specific cluster of people who have a money and appreciation. That is emerging. Here you have an opportunity, you can convince them. They have the money, and you can utilize the Pakistani-China Friendship Agreement. For that, you have to be available. For that, the display centers idea, as Mr. Irfan has said, we have mentioned, it needs investment and long-term approach. Only associations are a very, very big businessman. And if you don't do it, it will never happen. I give you an example. 10-12 years ago in Shanghai, I gave them idea when I was there that please display Pakistani designer products in a fashion show, because people are getting, and it's a very good fashion show. They don't support high-end designs, but not even the emerging, which are available. And I talked to a person, he never sent the portfolio. It is, we are talking, everyone is praising each other, but the reality is we need a thing. We need to show to the people, think that this is the thing, one and two hand. We can ask the five-star hotels. We can, I can assure you that if you send things to Chengdu, we will talk to a five-star hotel, and then we will arrange that. But we need the things to tell the people and to convince the people, you have to build the material. Our resources are here, whatever we have. So in that, permanent display is very important, and the thing has to be there, and the quality. We cannot, for example, if a person doesn't know it's handmade or that. I have some carpets in my office, some are machine made, but the designing is good. But I know that its quality is not good. I am just put it there. So from that point of view, from Pakistan, and they have to sell their product. We need the samples, the true samples, and the cost, and exact help they need. That is very, very important. Next 70th anniversary, Pakistani Display Center, inshallah, is going to open in Chengdu. Of course, it's off the way. They can send us the sample. We'll give it to them. They can display it. For that, everything is happening till you have that product. And if it is very high-end handmade, then the five-star hotels or the galleries, there are a lot of galleries, they can have this product. We are ready. We will support them. And we will work our best so that the place is provided free of cost. But other things the TDAP has to do are the exporter himself has to invest. Because we have to see that no lunch is free in the world. You have to put in money, earn money. So from that angle, everything is possible. You need the product and you need to invest on that. And it is a long haul. Chinese market is completely different from traditional markets our exporters know. It is entirely different. And here, and one point she mentioned, I would like to add, go for copyrights or geographical indicators of your ajrak if it is the product. Put it in the label. Go through the TDAP to the directly to the Chinese authorities in main trade fair. The maximum complaint for the quality of the food products of China. But next year, 95 were resolved. For Pakistan, a product got banned and it is banned still. The TDAP can play a role, consulates and embassies play a role, but the real person who has to earn money, he or she has to take the lead. That is very important. That point is missing, unfortunately. Thank you for patiently.
Ahmed, I would like to add one thing. So the important thing is, you know, their approach of exporter is very important. You know, we were making this this country pavilion in Nanning, the exhibition. You know, as I earlier told you, we are making that. But I asked TDAP to provide samples to display in the country pavilion. And that country pavilion, you know, that got all kind of media coverages and all kind of, you know, marketing, whatever you can think, it was available there. Online interviews, online, even on leading medias were there. Their governor was there. Their chairman of, you know, the region was there. Our ambassador was there. So you can think, जितना हाई प्रोफाइल हम उसको कर सकते थे हमने उसको किया बट इंटरेस्टिंगली व्हेन वी आर डिस्प्लेइंग द गुड्स टीडीएपी प्रोवाइडेड ओनली अ फ्यू थिंग्स फ्रॉम चेनवन एंड आई हैड नथिंग टू डिस्प्ले सो आई हैड टू यू नो प्रिंट फ्रॉम यू नो फ्रॉम गूगल इमेजेस सम यू नो समथिंग फ्रॉम टीडीएपी कैटलॉग्स इमेजेस So I all those things I printed it and I displayed as in pictures. So how can I market a product if I don't have? So that product needs to be sent to us so that we can tell people that this is our product, this is our unique design. जब बात आती है एग्जीबिटर्स को या एक्सपोर्टर्स को कुछ सैंपल प्रोवाइड करने की टीडीएपी को, तो वहां पे सैंपल्स नहीं आते, कमर्शियल सेक्शन के पास सैंपल्स नहीं पहुंचते. हमारे मेरे पास इतनी जगह है डिस्प्ले करने के लिए लेकिन सैंपल्स नहीं है. तो ये चीजें आप लोगों को खुद करनी है. सारे सुन रहे हैं तो मेरी एक हम्बल रिक्वेस्ट है कि ये चीजें आप लोगों ने खुद करनी है. अपनी प्रोडक्ट की मार्केटिंग आपने खुद करनी है. टीडीएपी को प्रॉपरली यूटिलाइज करें, कमर्शियल सेक्शन को प्रॉपरली यूटिलाइज करें. वी ऑल आर फॉर यू पीपल हेयर. सो हमें फीडिंग आप लोगों ने करनी है, हमें चीजें आप लोगों ने प्रोवाइड करनी है, तभी हम प्रॉपरली अपने अपने आप को प्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं इस मार्केट में, बल्कि पूरी दुनिया की जो मार्केट है. दिस वाज ऑल. थैंक यू वेरी मच.
Thank you very much, sir. It is indeed the case that the private sector needs to take a proactive role in marketing in international marketing, and to get their products through to the international market. So, sir, we're out of time for our webinar. So I would request any people who have any pending questions to please email those to us, and then we will forward those to the missions. We also have this webinar series recorded, so a recording will also be available in the YouTube, DDAP's YouTube webinar channel. So with this, I would like to profoundly thank Sir Mahmood Akhtar, Acting Consul General, for his very comprehensive overview and presentation on the Chengdu region, and I'm sure the participants greatly benefited from this. And I would also like to thank with deep gratitude Sir Muhammad Irfan, who very comprehensively gave us this entire market dynamics in the Guangzhou region, and I'm sure all of these exporters, we have serious exporters of handicrafts here, so that they were oriented about these regions, and I'm sure they will now be able to approach these markets with a lot more information and with a lot more confidence. So, sir, I thank both of you, sir, for taking out your valuable time and briefing our participants here. And I also like to thank our participants for participating in these series of webinars. And we will continue to explore market opportunities for handicraft products in the foreign markets. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ahmed. And we hope that now the exporters will contact us with the exact and specific details. Thank you very much for the welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you.